Hey, this is Supervisor James Gore. It's Monday. Want to give you an update on COVID-19 coronavirus, our stay at home out of the state version 2 that is implemented here locally. But more than anything, I want to speak to those of you out there that are struggling, either keeping your businesses open, paying your rent, figuring out which way the future goes, trying to understand how you manage Christmas. I want to let you know that as much as I try to make sure as a county elected official is that I hold our state and our federal government accountable for coordination, you all hold me accountable as well, and I honor that. And I hope this video can let you know where I stand on some certain things, where we stand, and what the future holds. And I'll keep posting these, but I also want people to continue to reach out and give us ground truth. It's the only way that I can share that ground truth with the governor's office and then with our federal representatives, primarily as we go through a presidential transition. First and foremost, this stay-at-home order, the difference between it and March is that we do not have a robust safety net in place. I was given the number recently by a local community leader that when we went through that first round of shelter in place in March, upwards of 1,500 businesses in Sonoma County, as just one sampling example, had used the PPP loan system to pay their employees to keep their business afloat. 1,500 of them had had at least $50,000 plus out of the PPP system. There is no such system right now. The state has announced a $500 million opening for emergency grants to businesses, upwards of 25,000. Those are not currently going out. I believe the RFP is open to be able to deploy those. This is a big thing for us. We're lobbying for that federal stimulus package, that $905 billion package to come, which would have PPP. It would have unemployment, enhanced unemployment insurance. It looks like right now it would not have the $1,200 checks that just go out, but maybe that will be included. And then it has support for testing, personal protective equipment, and also aid to local jurisdictions, counties, city governments, to be able to put that money into the community and stay afloat. Second thing is that Sonoma County is a part of the Bay Area region, announced by the governor's office a week and a half ago. We have implemented the enhanced stay-at-home order. Monterey, Santa Cruz, San Mateo, San Francisco, it's a big region. Us, Solano, Napa, Contra Costa, Alameda, the Bay Area region has a large ICU capacity. Sonoma County specifically, as a part of that region, does not have a large ICU capacity. We have a floor capacity that is measured at 68 ICU beds. An upward capacity in our three main hospitals and regional hospitals of around 100 to 110. That's at max. Last week, two of those big three hospitals, in conjunction with our health officer, talked about the significant surges they were facing and the issues they were having to keep those beds staffed. That was the reason for us joining the other Bay Area counties. I want folks to know that our system is very difficult to track on a percentage basis. A lot of what you're hearing out of the state is that if a region has less than 15% capacity in their staffed ICU beds, which is very difficult to train more people for or design more systems for, the staffed ICU beds, is that if they have less than 15%, they have to implement these measures. The Bay Area as a whole is right on the cusp of that 15%. Sonoma County, our measurement through that 68 beds, it's been much less than 15%, but it's tough to measure those numbers like many in a community of our size, much less a small rural community. But we have 500,000 people with 68 beds. We could switch between 2% and 27% in 2 to 3 days' time. So it's really about the ability of our healthcare network to handle that and what percentage of those ICU beds are full of COVID patients in critical care. I think we all understand, and I personally believe that COVID is serious to the point that it kills people. It primarily kills our most vulnerable individuals, people with comorbidities, people with underlying conditions. We cannot be in a situation where those of us who might not get sick from COVID infect those who are at the most dangerous, but we have to continue to do not just a good job, but a better job through the state regulation of our skilled nursing facilities and our elder care facilities, privately run, and also those locked facilities that we manage to make sure that those vulnerable populations are protected. There's a lot of people throughout California that are in a position where they want to live with risk. And I believe that is rational and reasonable. They say, why can't I eat outside if those numbers aren't directly correlated with transmission of the disease or heightened? Why can't I take my kid to a playground if I can do that? Why can't I go to my hair salon if they are trained in sanitation, are conducting low risk, highly managed business? I want to state that the way that these shelter in place orders, whether I and you like them or not, is that they are using the only tool they have directed by the state, which is a shutdown of opportunities to be out and to cause disease transmission. So even if being out at a outdoor dining, as we saw in the case of LA, where there was a court case that said that you have to show there's a direct correlation between heightened transmission rates and outdoor dining. Even if they don't show that, what is happening with the government right now is it's trying to decrease disease transmission with the things that it does have control over, which is institutions. Those are businesses, nonprofits. In this sense, I lead a group of frustrated pastors, faith-based houses of worship, churches, who are saying, why am I, if I've been compliant, shut down if you can't manage household gatherings and other kinds of personal gatherings, which are causing a lot of these case rates? There is an understanding. We have pushed on the governor's office for a strategy to approach that and to approach winning over people in terms of their personal behavior, because at the same time, we have to do these measures, these esoteric kind of draconian measures, if things get too high and if it gets very scary, like right now, where there is concern in certain parts of our state of an ICU overcapacity and people having to choose between who gets a ventilator and who doesn't, and all the other things that we've seen in New York, some of the Dakotas, and other places where the healthcare system has, in fact, buckled. At the same time, many of you, like me, all of us are trying to figure out a way that this doesn't continue to be a mallet that hits indiscriminately. And whether you're compliant or not, it smacks you, and how it can be a scalpel instead. That is good government, is when you go after direct causing correlation in events instead of just wielding a mallet. At the same time, in our coordination, not just from me in Sonoma County, but as a leader for counties around the state through the California State Association of Counties, we are in conjunction of bringing that ground truth to the state to make sure that we continue to adapt, and that we don't just continue to change the metrics every week to try and figure out the right fit, which is in fact changing the goalposts. We have a good coordination. I'm the president of California State Association of Counties. Good coordination with the health and Human Services Secretary Mark Galli, with the cabinet, and a good coordination with the governor's office. They feel that this shelter in place, excuse me, they don't like to call it shelter in place, call it stay at home order, is their last effort in terms of trying to bend the curve back. And their goal was to do that within 3 weeks before Christmas. My goal going forward, have a call tonight with folks in the governor's office and going forward with my county colleagues from throughout the 58 counties in the state, is to continue to push for a strategy of not just the way in to managing this, but the way out. There is a glimmer on the horizon that is also impacting these decisions, and it's the vaccine coming out. Sonoma County is projected to have in hand and deployed 10,000 doses, 5,000 of the Pfizer and 5,000 of the Moderna vaccines before the end of this calendar year. That's 10,000 for a community of 500,000. Priority is to intensive care nurses, home care individuals, people who are with or in high risk categories. That doesn't include me. At the same time, I want to make sure that I stress that as those come in and as we sprint towards the vaccine, the goal of the state and for us locally is to keep transmission rates low. But at the same time, it is, as you and I know, it needs to be better because it is buckling people because there is not a safety net like there was in March. In March, we had enhanced unemployment benefits. We had PPP loans going to small businesses. I heard that in Sonoma County, there was 1,500 businesses that received at least $50,000 or more in PPP loans. There was also the $1,200 checks that went out to individuals. We are lobbying viscerally with the state. As I mentioned before, we are lobbying with the federal government, and we are doing our best to make sure that there are resources on the table. There are far too many people in our community, renters, small business owners, workers, who are suffering in the shadows, and in many cases, because of COVID, dying in the shadows. There is a wet blanket effect of this stay-at-home order and all of our disasters on our community and many of your communities that is crippling people. The depression, the anxiety rates, the danger of suicides, the danger of substance abuse, all these other things are very real. We are in this to beat this pandemic and to come out of it stronger. I want you to stay in touch with me, whether good, bad, or indifferent. My job as government, as a part of the royal we of government, is that I have to be accountable to you, and I have to make sure that those I speak to are accountable to us. So please keep it coming. We'll continue to provide updates as we can. My goal is to work with the state specifically on behalf of Sonoma County and counties throughout the state to not just find a way in, but a way out based on whether these current efforts bend the curve and transmission rates drop, or if they don't, and we have to figure out other ways that we achieve harm reduction and the idea of people living with risk and living with COVID as we stretch and sprint towards a vaccine. Recently, I heard Dr. Fauci speak, head of infectious disease, the Fed, saying he's hopeful, optimistic, hopeful that we will be able to have vaccines widely distributed by April. That's a long ways off. I wish I was here sharing better news. I love you. I honor you. I honor your work and what you're doing in your resilience and struggling to survive these chaotic times. Not just the pandemic, but for our part here in Sonoma County, this is one of 8 declared disasters in the last 6 years. We've been through fires, floods, drought, pandemic. We got homeless crisis, working on RV encampments and regular homeless encampments and outreach and putting as much as we can towards everything. But as you all know, we are in crazy times, and my commitment is to be accountable to you and to keep stepping forward. It's the only way to do it. Only thing I ask is please, if you can, shop locally, adopt a family, give if you are privileged, if you have a steady salary right now, help others, create opportunities for people to work on your property. Get out there and do something that you can do to help your fellow man, woman, and community members. Thank you so much. Let's have a good week.